Hello everyone, welcome to Bharat Kranti online classes. In this course earlier we have already discussed about United Nations General Assembly, Security Council and Economic and Social Council. So we will discuss the remaining three principal organs here: Secretariat, International Court of Justice and Trusteeship Council. You already know about us. We have already seen how the whole UN system works. So let's start with UN Secretariat. What is UN Secretariat? UN Secretariat composes of Secretary General and thousands of international UN staff members. It is a bureaucratic organization. It carries out the day-to-day work of the UN, mandated by the General Assembly and other organization principal organs. So all the other bodies recommends policies, finalizes policy and everything. Who does the actual work? It is the Secretariat. UN Secretariat does the actual work on the ground. So Secretary General is the face of the UN. He is the chief administrative officer of the organization, appointed by General Assembly. So who elects UNSC members? General Assembly. Who elects Economic and Social Council members? It is also General Assembly. Who appoints Secretary General of UN Secretariat? It is also General Assembly. But this is based on recommendation of Security Council, and Secretary General is appointed for a 5-year term, renewable term. This is current Secretary General of UN, Mr. Antonio Guterres. He already served for 5 years and he also won another term for the next 5 years. So he was UN Secretary General from 2017 to 21 for 5 years. Now he will be the Secretary General for the next 5 years also. Recently on 18th June 2021, he won the second term as Secretary General of UN. So UN staff members are recruited internationally and locally and work in duty stations and on peacekeeping missions all around the world. So that is a brief about UN Secretariat. Now, International Court of Justice. International Court of Justice, also known as World Court. You see here, it is located in The Hague, Netherlands. It is the inside picture of this International Court of Justice. There are 15 judges. All of these judges are elected by General Assembly also. And each of these judges are elected for 9-year terms. And not more than one nationality may be represented on a court. There are 15 judges. They should be from 15 different countries. No country should have two judges at a time. And all of these judges must collectively reflect the principle, civilizations and legal systems of the world. They do not work for their respective countries. They work for the whole world. They work for the UN. It is a world court. And it was established in June 1945. And it is the successor of Permanent Court of International Justice. As you must be knowing, there is a League of Nations before the UN. League of Nations was not so successful, especially because US is not at all involved in League of Nations. In 1945, League of Nations was revamped into UN. UN was formed in 1945 because League of Nations was not successful. And then Permanent Court of International Justice reformed as International Court of Justice. So what is the main purpose of this International Court of Justice? To settle disputes of international law and to advise organs on legal questions. Other organs like Economic and Social Council, Security Council, General Assembly, International Court of Justice suggests legal advices, gives legal advices to the other organs. And it also settles disputes of international law between the member countries. So there are 15 judges. They are independent ones selected. They do not represent their country. They are independent and they work for the whole world. And they are elected for 9-year terms. And it is located in The Hague. Trusteeship Council, it was established in 1945. To understand Trusteeship Council, you must know about something called League of Nations mandate. After the First World War, after the end of First World War, winners are US, Britain, France, Italy, etc. And losers are Germany, Austria, and Turkey, etc. So there are some territories of these losing countries, there are some colonies of these losing countries which are taken over by the winning countries. So in the name of League of Nations, all of these territories which were previously governed by these losing nations, which are called central powers, all of these territories were transferred to few winning countries and they are called trust territories. Those territories are called trust territories and each country was made responsible for a respective territory. Like Syria was given to France. Now it is the responsibility of the France to make Syria self-government and independent, to give proper governance to Syria. It is the responsibility. On paper, it is like you are taking extra responsibility, but in reality, it is nothing but colonization. Similarly, Israel-Palestina. At that time, there was no Israel. It is called Palestina. It was given to Britain. So these are examples of trust territories. So after the World War I, some territories were handed over to some winning countries. And after the Second World War, after the seizing of this League of Nations ended and it is reformed as United Nations. They became United Nations trust territories. And to manage all of these trust territories of the UN, something called Trusteeship Council was formed. But we have seen there are many independent movements. By the end of 20th century, almost all of the countries in the world became independent. So all trust territories attained self-government or independence. So from on 1994, November 1, Trusteeship Council was suspended. It is currently inactive. It was not completely removed. It is still in the structure of UN system, but it is suspended. It is not operating currently. So this is a brief about Trusteeship Council. We have seen International Court of Justice and UN Secretariat also. That's it, my friends. That's it about principal organs of the UN. In our next video, we will discuss about specialized agencies of the UN, followed by other important organs in the UN system. And in the end, we will discuss about related organizations which are outside of the UN system but work in close coordination with the UN. So that's it. Thank you.